All right, so there's going to be some special cases that we're going to see in factoring. We've been working with factoring. Our special cases are going to be 50 through 57. Okay, so first of all, the method that I showed you guys, you know, an X method, it works all the time. So let me do it the long way first. The long way in this case is I'm going to call it long way only when it's a special case. And you're going to see in a minute why I call it special case. Now, I'm looking for two numbers that when I multiplied equals 36. And remember, I multiply 4 times 9. That's how I got that 36. But when I add my numbers, it's equal to negative 12. Okay, so I'm going to be dealing with two negatives, right? Because multiplied equals positive 36, added equals negative 12. So I'm dealing with two negative numbers. Now we can think of the factors of 36, right? What are the numbers that multiplied equals 36? And we can say, well, 1 times 36, 2 times 18, right? 3 times 12, 4 times 9, and 6 times 6. I'm really looking for which numbers multiplied equals 36, which I have my list, but when I add them, it's equal to 12. Well, we can say, well, 6 and 6, right? So my answer here will be 6 and 6. Now, because my first number is not a 1, I don't go straight to parentheses. I'm just going to split my middle term, and I'm going to call this 4x to the second minus 6x minus 6x plus 9. Notice I split my middle term. Now, when I look at my first two, because now that I have four terms, I'm going to do grouping. When I do the first two, I can divide each by 2x. Right? We talk about factoring the greatest common factor out. I can divide each by 2x. So I'm going to do the distributive property backwards. So again, each of my terms, I'm going to divide it by 2. Each number, I'm going to divide it by 2. And for my x's, I'm going to remove 1 from the exponent. So my result gives me 2x minus 3. Okay. Now, when I look at the last two terms here, I can divide each by 3. But as a matter of fact, I want the first, when I do my parentheses, I want my parentheses to start with a positive. So in this case, let me factor a negative 3. I'm going to divide a neg, I'm going to factor a negative 3. So I'm going to get inside my parentheses 2x minus 3. So my parentheses is going to be 2x minus 3 to begin with, because it's the parentheses that matches, right? 2x minus 3. But interesting part is that my other parentheses, it's also going to be 2x minus 3. And I get that from what I have out here. Now, I want to call it special case because I get the same parentheses twice. Now, when we type this, it will be 2x minus 3, 2x minus 3. If we were to write this, we could just write 2x minus 3 and then to the second, which means I have the same parentheses twice. Now, this was the long way, to be honest. This was the long way. Now, let me show you the short way. Let me erase this. I show you the long way to show you that it works. To be honest, when I'm looking at this, the first thing I'm going to see if this is a special case, I'm going to do the square root of the first number and the square root of the last number. So what's the square root of 4x squared? Well, 2x, right? The square root, not just the half. The square root of 4, the square root of x squared, so 2x. And then what's the square root of 9? Well, 3. If these two terms multiplied, 2x times 3 is equal to the half of 12x, then it's a special case, right? 2x times 3 is 6x, right? It's the half of 12x. So it's a special case because the term in the middle has a minus, I'm going to put a minus here, and I'm just going to have the 2x to the third. I'm going to have it twice. See how faster that was? So my answer basically would be 2x minus 3 and 2x minus 3. Cool. Let's take a look at number 51. Now this trick works only for special cases, right? So let me take a look. 51. I'm gonna do the square root of 4r squared. Isn't that 2r? I'm gonna do the square root of 25, which is 5. Now I'm gonna multiply these two terms. 2r times 5, that's 10r, which is the half. So keep in mind, when I multiply those two terms, it has to equal to half of the middle term, right? 10r is the half of 10, of 20r. Cool. So it is a special case because my middle term, it's plus 20r. I'm going to respect the sign. So I'm going to have plus, so 2r plus 5, I'm going to have it twice. Okay, so the way I'm going to type this will be 2r plus 5 and 2r plus 5. I'm literally going to write 2r plus 5 twice. When you type this, no spaces, all together, so no spaces, all right? All right, let's take a look at number 52. Oh, what happens when we have only two terms? We know the X thing works. The X thing works when there's three terms, right? The diamond method that I called. So we could rewrite this as b squared plus 0b minus 25. Notice how I added 0b. So I could have three terms. Let me make that zero better because it looks like an O. All right. Notice I added the middle term, 0b, just so I can see three terms. And I know on the diamond method, I'm basically looking for two numbers that multiplied equals negative 25. But when I add, it's equal to zero. Okay. So you guys might be thinking, well, positive 5 and negative 5, right? Now, because my first letter is a B, just my first number, it's a 1. Okay, because my first number is a 1, I'm just going to go straight to parentheses, and I'm going to write this as B plus 5 and B minus 5. Now, you might be thinking, there's a shorter way. There must be, it's a special case. It must be a thing here. Yes, let me erase this. Let me show you a rule that we call the difference of the squares. Okay, now the difference of the square, it has to have a minus in between. And let me rewrite this as b squared minus 5 squared. Notice I wrote everything as square. Again, this rule is called difference of the square. So it has to have a minus and squares. B squared, 5 squared. That says that one of my parentheses will be B plus 5 and the other one B minus 5. Right? B squared, so I get B. 5 squared, I get 5. One of my parentheses has a plus, the other one has a minus. Which one comes first? It doesn't matter. All right, so following that idea, let me take a look at number 53. I can write this as 5p all squared minus 4 squared. Okay, so difference of the squares. I wrote everything as squares. Now my answer would be 5p plus 4 and 5p minus 4. So one is a plus, one is a minus. Which one comes first? It doesn't matter. All right, let's take a look at number 54. Now with the cubes, now notice how this is x to the third. Okay, so now this one's going to change a little. Now for the third, we're going to use difference or addition of everything to the third. Let me rewrite this as x to the third minus 4 to the third. So everything to the third. Okay, so now this is going to be interesting. My first parenthesis is going to be x minus 4. You guys can see where I got that from. X minus 4. Okay. My second parenthesis. To begin with, let me take a look at this term right here. Square that. So multiply by itself. X times x. X squared. Then let me take a look at this term at the end. 4 times 4 is 16, right? Or negative 4 times negative 4, it's positive 16. So my first parent, my second parenthesis will start with x squared and will end with a plus 16. Now there's a term in the middle. Okay, for the term in the middle, first thing I do is I look at this sign. It's a minus. So here I'm going to write it opposite, so plus. If it was a plus to begin with, I will write minus. So switch the sign. And then I'm going to multiply these two terms. X times 4 or 4 times x gives me 4x. And that's it. Okay. Let's take a look at another example. Let me write this as everything to the third. So I'm going to write this as 2 to the third plus x to the third. So my first parenthesis will be 2 plus x. My second parenthesis, it's going to start with a 4 and it's going to end with an x squared. Because remember, I went 2 squared, that's why I got the 4. X squared, so like that's how I got the x squared. Now, the interesting part is the sign, the term in the middle. I see a plus sign, so I'm going to go minus, opposite sign. And then I'm going to multiply 2 times x. So 2x. Let me do something really quick with 56 and 57, right? Because we're going to work up until 57 today. Let me practice this cube stuff again. Let me go to number 56 right here. Let me write everything to the third. So I'll have 2x all to the third plus 5 to the third. Okay, so my first parenthesis will be 2x plus 5. Now my second parenthesis will start with 4x squared and it's going to finish with a plus 25. For those of you that are still wondering, 2x times 2x, it's 4x squared. At the end, 5 times 5, 25. So notice I squared each of my terms. Now my middle term will be with a minus. The reason why, because this is a plus. So I go minus, opposite sign. And then I'm going to go 2x times 5. That's going to be 10x. Okay, so let's take a look at one more example here. The negative at the beginning. So I'm just going to write negative 4x all to the third, right? Because negative 4 to the third is negative 64 plus 3 to the third. I use my parentheses in the first part just because negative 4x is negative 64x to the third. Okay, so my first parentheses will be negative 4x plus 3. My second parentheses, so let's take a look. Negative 4x times negative 4x is 16x to the second. 3 times 3 finish with a plus 9. Okay, I know my sign in the middle is minus. right? The minus. But then I'm going to multiply negative 4x times 3. So that will give me a negative 12x. Okay. Remember how back in pre-algebra, you learned that when there's two negative signs, basically becomes a plus sign. So that minus a negative, let me replace that as a plus. So my answer, one of my parentheses is negative 4x plus 3. The other parentheses, 16x squared plus 12x plus 9. Let me zoom out so you guys can see what we did today. There we go.